systems in China. The government saying all public entertainment will be canceled tomorrow out of respect for the more than 2,000 people killed in last week's major earthquake. 195 people are still missing, by the way. And just yesterday, we saw two more survivors pulled from that rubble. China, Chile, Haiti, Mexico, all major earthquakes in recent months. So is the U.S. next? Scientists think that we are due for a big one. And CNN's Ted Rollins investigates.
They have three firefighters trapped trying to assist with them.
Members of the Los Angeles Fire Department's urban search and rescue team pull victims from a collapsed structure after an 8.0 earthquake.
Okay, we'll get you help in just a second.
This is just a drill, but since feeling the recent 7.2 quake in Mexico and seeing the devastation from other recent quakes, the 7.0 in Haiti, the 8.8 off the coast of Chile, and the 6.9 in China, many Californians think the earth is rumbling more than normal. And according to the numbers, they're right, sort of. California and Baja Mexico have had more than 80 earthquakes this year of 4.0 magnitude or higher, more than double the number in all of 2009. But Caltech seismologist Dr. Kate Hutton points out that all but a handful of those 80 were aftershocks from the Mexican quake. If you take that into account, she says the numbers are about normal. So what does that mean when it comes to determining whether the big one is imminent?
I can't say it's not. You know, it's not going to happen, but it's I don't think it's any different than any other week or month.
The scientists may not think anything is brewing, but online, the predictions are flying. Luke Thomas, who has no formal scientific training, says he uses ground temperatures to predict earthquakes. He told us on his webcam from his home in Florida that he believes Southern California will be hit with a 5.7 quake or higher in the next few days.
Are you hoping for an earthquake so you're right?
Well, sort of, but I hope it hits where nobody's living.
Slowly.
While nobody knows for certain when or where the big one will hit, seismologists do believe that drills like this one are a good idea because experts and laymen do agree on one thing, that sooner or later, it is coming.
And seismologists say that this is a prime candidate, the San Andreas, to produce a major earthquake because it hasn't produced one in hundreds of years. Of course, for all of us living in California, we hope it holds off for a few hundred more. Ted Rollins, CNN, Los Angeles.
And from the earth rumbling to Iceland's volcano blowing up, the annoying ash story has just about everybody talking, and it's giving our late night comics plenty of new material to spew.
Unbelievable story. The volcanic ash from Iceland continues to disrupt air travel all over Europe. Everything's gone. Commercial flights, private jets, the only thing still flying, Toyotas. Those are the only ones still.
The big Icelandic volcano, it's called Eyjafjallajökull.
Oop. Nice to that.
Hey, yeah. I forgot your yogurt.
That's a.
Hey.
Whoa.
Well, it blew up in Iceland, and the big volcanic cloud is drifting to New York. Were you aware of that coming to New York City? Oh. And they say that actually the air quality of the city is improving.
Right.
As you probably know, a volcano on the tiny island of Iceland has shut down air travel all across Europe. Apparently, I guess they dumped too much baking soda and vinegar into the thing, and it just won't stop erupting. 63,000 flights have been canceled. An estimated 40,000 Americans are stuck in Europe right now because of the ash cloud. President Obama had to cancel his trip to Poland. This morning, he said he hopes the volcano will stop smoking soon, and the volcano said the same thing about him.